Movie Demon here. Today, I'll show you a Korean mystery thriller film called Forgotten. The movie starts with a young boy waking up in his parents' car while his dad drives it. His name is Jin-seok. His mother asks him if he's alright while his older brother is sitting in the front seat of the car. They were actually shifting into a new house. His brother mentions that he did not sleep last night because he was way too excited to move into the new house, and everyone laughs. Just outside their new home, Jin-seok realizes that even though this is the first time he is seeing the new house, it feels like he has seen it before. His elder brother Yusu interrupts, asking him what he thinks about the new house, and we are introduced to his elder brother. Yusu is a brilliant young man who graduated at the top of his university. He showed his talent in every area of life ever since they were kids, and not just in studies but musical instruments and sports as well. He is very well mannered and helps at home as well. He doesn't drink or smoke, and everyone admires him, including his younger brother, as he is a little slow in studies and other fields as well. Yusu got into a car accident last year and has a leg injury, making him drag his left leg. They move in and some workers help them move the stuff into the house. Yusu hangs the calendar while Jin-seok helps with the books. He notices a closed door and asks his brother about it, to which he tells him that the old owner of the home has left some of his stuff in that room, but they will be able to use the room just within a few days. When Yusu goes out, a worker asks Jin-seok if he really is his older brother. He laughs and says yes, while Yusu comes into the room and asks the worker to leave. At night, Jin-seok hears a strange voice coming from the same room and asks his family, and they tell him that it's just the rainy weather. Later, when his brother goes to sleep, while listening to music, he hears a loud voice coming from the same room, and this time he goes to check. He walks towards the room slowly when suddenly someone touches him from behind, but it's just Yusu. They both listen closely to the door but hear nothing, and Yusu asks him if he had taken his medication. They both go out for a walk to get some fresh air when their dad calls Yusu, as he has to give him some documents, and Jin-seok goes back to listening to his music. While on the way back, however, Yusu is kidnapped by some strangers, and Jin-seok runs after him to help his brother. The van gets away, but he manages to remember the number plate of the van. He runs back home to tell his parents about what had happened and then goes unconscious. He wakes up the next day only to find his brother gone. His parents call the cops, and two detectives come to their home the next day to check up on everything. He tells them the number plate of the van, but one of the detectives tells him that there is no van in the whole country with that number. Days go by and his brother is nowhere to be found, and his health starts to get bad. He has nightmares at night, and after 19 days, he wakes up to find his elder brother back home out of nowhere. His brother, however, does not remember anything after the night of his abduction. Jin-seok, nevertheless, is very happy for his brother's return. The two brothers go to sleep after a short chat, but Jin-seok wakes up at night only to find his brother's bed empty. He ignores, thinking that he might have gone to toilet, and goes back to sleep. Jin-seok misses his medicine in the morning when a tablet goes under the shelf and the two brothers have their breakfast. After the meal, Yusu gets up and leaves for the office when Jin-seok notices him dragging his right leg instead of the left one. Upon asking, he dodges the question by saying that he doesn't have time for the jokes. Jin-seok also ignores, thinking that he might have been mistaken himself. The same night, Jin-seok goes to sleep on the study table because he's studying late when Yusu comes, takes a pencil, and targets his brother's eyeball. He keeps on clicking the pencil until the lid of the pencil drops, as if he has a lot of anger for his brother. He goes out after that, but Jin-seok is awake this time and he decides to follow him. A little far away, Jin-seok sees his brother walking down the road with his injured leg, when suddenly his leg becomes fine and he starts walking like a normal person. He gets into a taxi and leaves, while Jin-seok is still following him. The car stops in a very shady place where Jin-seok gets out and starts smoking, which surprises his brother because he never smokes. He sees him meeting two men who are the same detectives that came to their house for the investigation. The two men further call him boss and take orders from him. The two men, however, see him and start to chase him, but in the end, Jin-seok grabs him from behind and makes him unconscious. He wakes up the next day on his study table while his brother is sleeping on the bed nearby. He gets all scared as his brother wakes up and runs to the toilet and locks himself up. Yusu follows him to the toilet and asks if everything is fine, at which he gets angry and says that he knows his secret. He further reveals that he knows that he is an imposter and not his brother. He then grabs an iron pipe and goes out, and the two start to struggle when Yusuk overpowers him and politely asks if he had taken his medicine, which he did not. He tells him that he is only getting visions about the taxi and last night only because he did not take his medicine, and finally he is able to calm him down. Jin-seok then says sorry to his brother. He then leaves for his office, and Jin-seok goes back to his study where he sees the lead of the pencil which he saw last night, and that's when he realizes that it was not a dream at all. He also realizes that he never told his brother about the taxi chase, but he knew about it already. With all the information, he realizes that the person who came back posing as his brother was not his brother and just an imposter. He tells all of this to his mother as soon as she comes back home, scaring her as well. They decide to chase him again at night when he goes out with his father so that they can make sure that he is actually an imposter and it's not just the delusion of Jin-seok. It rains that night when Jin-seok hears his mother talking to someone over the phone. He peeks into the room only to find his mother telling everything to someone over the phone, saying that he knows all of it was true. Jin-seok somehow manages to jump out of the house, but he finds his father waiting outside, who orders him to get back to the house, while his mother also comes at the scene. Only then he realizes that all of them are imposters and he gets confused where his real family is. He gets really afraid but somehow manages to run away and get to the police station and tells everything to the real cops. The cop confirms his age and he says 21, while the cop gets very confused and tells him that he is actually 41 because it's 2014 now. Jin-seok's mind is blown away by this and he gets really confused as it's only 1997, but the cop tells him to take a look at the TV where he sees Donald Trump getting elected. He then takes a look around him and sees the signs of the modern world. He then accidentally takes a look into the mirror only to find a 41-year-old man instead of a 21-year-old young boy. He gets even more confused and goes back to the house and starts to call everyone. He notices that the door of that mysterious room was now open and he could hear music coming from inside. He sees blood on the piano where a dummy is laying in front of him and he gets confused further. Then all the members come in and Jin-seok asks them what they've done to him, but Yusuk focuses on one question only, which is if he really cannot remember anything. While Jin-seok is further confused by this, he says with a sigh that they have failed once again and then explains what happened 20 years ago. He tells him that a woman and a girl were brutally murdered in the same room 20 years ago. The police tried but could not find the killer and everyone eventually forgot about the case, so the family of the victims hired a private investigator who finally found the killer. It was Jin-seok. They interrogated him and tortured him again and again, but he told them that he did not murder anyone. Seeing him go through the interrogation and getting the same answer again and again, they believed him and called an hypnosis expert from the police department. He advised to recreate the scene of the night of the death and try to make him remember, as they knew that he was the killer, but the victim's family could not take revenge because he could not remember anything whatsoever. They planned to make him remember everything by having him hypnotized and the hypnosis expert acting as his father and the private investigator Yusuk as his elder brother. They gave him a story to believe, which he did. The voices that Jin-seok heard from the mysterious room were actually their own men who were decorating the room from inside, making it the same as the night of the murder. When moving into the home, the worker also asked if Yusuk really was his older brother, because Jin-seok was 41 years old and claiming that a 22 years old boy was his older brother. The new house also seemed familiar because he had been there. They were doing it to make him remember and tell him if someone else also helped him in the murder and who ordered the killing, because there was nothing stolen from the house. Jin-seok also had no relationship with the family, so why did he kill them? That's why it was very important for the fake family to have Jin-seok's memory back. Everything was according to the plan until the investigator was taken by the police because of fraud on the rainy night, due to which Jin-seok thought that his older brother was being abducted. He also did not take the medicine afterwards, which caused him to come out of the hypnosis. Under hypnosis, sleep drugs are a necessity and his sleep started to have distortions. 19 days later, the private investigator came out by bribing the police. Now that they all think that Jin-seok would never regain his memory, the investigator tells him that they're going to give him a beating and kill him eventually. Jin-seok, however, jumps out of the car and they end up chasing him. During the chase down, they both get into a car accident and pass out. Jin-seok wakes up in a hospital and everything starts to come back to him because his memory had been triggered due to the accident. He remembers everything even before the accident as well. 20 years ago, Jin-seok was a normal person. His elder brother was the same kind of a person as it was told in the start of the movie. Jin-seok went to a park with his family and on the way back, they got into a car accident, which was his last happy memory. This is also the reason why the 41 years old Jin-seok was hypnotized and woke up in a car. His parents died in the car accident and his brother was in a very serious condition at the hospital. That was the time when the country was going through a crisis and the doctor told him that his brother needed an operation as soon as possible. If the operation did not happen, his brother could even lose his life. Jin-seok was a student at the time and could not find any job. He starts to look for a job online by mentioning his brother's condition when a man sends him an offer for a big amount of money, but he has to kill someone. He reluctantly accepts the offer after thinking over it. The man gave him the address and told him to kill the woman only and leave the two kids alone. Jin-seok went to the house on the same night but felt guilty while doing so and changed his mind. He tried to go back when the woman woke up thinking that her husband was back but starts screaming when she sees Jin-seok with a knife. He somehow manages to calm her down but her daughter comes downstairs giving the same reaction. Her daughter doesn't stop screaming at all and runs to the door and Jin-seok runs after her. They struggle for a while and Jin-seok accidentally ends up killing her. Then her mother also starts screaming and to shut her up and erase the evidence, Jin-seok also kills her. When he is about to leave, however, he meets a little boy who asks him for his mother and sister. Jin-seok told the kid to count from 1 till 100 under the bedsheet and they will come back. On the way out, he notices that this was the family of the doctor that was treating his brother. When the kid sees his mother and sister dead after the counting, he starts crying and calls his dad. Jin-seok knew that his instructor was the doctor himself and asks him for the reason why he paid him to kill his own wife. The doctor tells him that the only reason for this is the insurance money which he would get after the death of his wife. He says that he has two kids and it's really hard for him in the crisis. He refuses to pay him and they both start to fight, and after a struggle, the doctor falls down from the rooftop. This caused Jin-seok to suffer from amnesia and he was only able to remember till the accident and nothing after that. When he wakes up at the hospital bed again, he tells the investigator who is filling the injection with poison to kill him that he remembers everything now. The investigator tells him that he is that same kid who counted from 1 till 100 on the night of the murder of his old family. He further asks him if his father was the actual person who ordered the killing. Jin-seok refuses and takes it all on himself and clears his father's name out. After listening to Jin-seok, he realizes that his father was the actual person who ordered the killing, as he also signed up for the life insurances just months prior to the killing. He feels his life as meaningless and commits suicide by jumping out of the building. Jin-seok also feels more guilty than ever as all of this had happened because of him. Jin-seok picks up the poisonous injection and injects himself, also committing suicide. This is without a doubt one of the best Korean films that I have seen and totally worth a watch. Subscribe to the channel for more such videos and leave a like and a comment to help the channel out.